Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes it as kitabun mubarakun, a book full of barakah. You ask, what kind of barakah is in the Qur'an? Barakah in everything. Barakah in its reward. Yani reading Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad is equal to reading a third of the Qur'an in reward. Barakah in the family, barakah in the wife, barakah in the money, barakah in the children, barakah in your health, barakah in everything. Allah Azza wa Jal described it as such. Kitabun anzalnahu ilayka mubarakun. Subhanallah. Yani most of the problems in our life is because Qur'an is not part of our life. Most of the problems in our life is because there's no Qur'an in your life. Well, Qur'an is a protection. It's a protection. Yani from diseases, not only that, but even from what affects the people, which is from the evil eye, and the sihr, and the hasad, and all of that. Al-Qur'an is a protection for this. I end with one story. One story, and I finish with this. There was a woman. And this woman, yani, of course, she was rich, she was beautiful, and this is a recent story, it's true, it happened in one of the Arab countries. She's still alive. But yani, subhanAllah, the Sheikh Nasim will see for you later. Anyway, for this woman, she's alive, and this is her case, and she wanted to get married. For someone like her, not yani, like Nasim, someone like her, in the same rank, he was also yani, a person of money. He was a person of money and a person of looks and so on. Anyway, he approached the father and he says, I approach and I want to marry your daughter. I ask for her hand. For he said to him, okay, no worries, let me seek permission from the daughter. This is something that you must do. As a father, you don't just decide, you need to give the decision back to the girl herself, just like Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam did with the marriage of Zainab radiallahu anha. For he went, the father went to the daughter and he said to her, this man, this is 1, 2, 3, he's this, and he has money, and this is his position, this is his work, you are interested in marriage or not? She says to him, and here, mashallah, she's a righteous woman. She said, I want to ask about his religion. How is he with his religion? How is he with his salat? They said, yeah, and he's not, they're not all there. And he sometimes salah, some, she said, I don't want him. Khalas, I don't want him. The father said, wallahi, akhi, yani, there's no part for you in our family, and she doesn't want you because of your deed. He says, Allah, how? Yani, how does someone say no to me? I'm this and I'm that. Wallah, I'm going to get married to her no matter what. For he went to magicians. He went to some magicians. And he said to them, the story, this is my story and I need to get married to her and find me a solution. They said to him, Allah, we can find you a solution, but it's going to cost you money. He says, money, Allah, take whatever you want. Find me a solution. They said, khalas, come tomorrow, your application will be ready and finished. He went. He came the next day. And the magician said, Allah, Allah, your case was too heavy for me. You need to go to the other expert. There's another expert magician in another city. Go to him and probably he can solve your case. For he went to it and he said to him, this is my case and so on. And someone else lower in your rank, he directed me to you. He said, you have more power than him and please help in my situation. I need this woman. For he began to work on his case and he called him a few days later and he says, wallahi, I can't do anything. Go to كبيرون الذي علمنا السحر. Go to the top one in the country. There's no one bigger than this guy in magic. For he went to him. And he too, after a few days, gave him the same response. He said to him, listen, my brother, I sent to her المرده من الشياطين. Yeah, المرده هو في جن, في شيطان. And there's a مرده من الشياطين. المرده are the worst kind of devils. He said, I sent them to her and they could not do anything. This woman reads Surah Al-Baqarah every night before she sleeps. She reads Surah Al-Baqarah every night before she sleeps. This is the solution. When one has the Quran, seeks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeks closeness to Allah through the Quran, Allah will take care of such a person. He'll protect him from what happens. For I say to you, my brothers and sisters, wallahi, most of the problems in our life is because from the Quran, we're away. From the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we're away. And I give it to my brother, Sheikh Nasim, to continue in this topic.